lives one day at a time. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. They're here to get your day going fine. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elations Radio.
And here's your host, Miss Kim Robinson.
Get ready, Connecticut. The queen of gospel, winner of multiple Grammy and several awards. 40 years, 40 albums. Ladies and gentlemen, Pastor Shirley Stephen. Saturday, October 7th at Hill House Auditorium. It's a live concert with Pastor Shirley Caesar at the Hollaback Excellence Awards Show. Tickets are on sale at Kevin's Seafood and Rubber Match in New Haven, Connecticut, and also at Jimmy's Clothing in Bridgeport, Connecticut. For more information, call Big Tone at area code 203-314-4839 or email hollabackgospelawards.com. This is another Big Tone production.
My crown and bow before the throne. wanna get there one day.
Amen, amen, and praise the Lord, everybody. This is Beauty Cooper, I'm coming before you today from the heart, amen. This is On the Couch with Beauty, representing Lacey Mother Green. Amen. Glory to God. Everything that we do for the glory of God. Amen. And, you know, I just choose today to, and sometimes I do this often, but I just choose today to come before you with my heart in my hand, because I as much as I preach the word and teach the word, I have to make it applicable to us. I have to make it up, because sometimes it just don't reach a person until we make it apply to our lives. And so I'm coming off script today with you, and I'm talking to you from the heart, okay? What I'm talking to us today is going to be about the setup for our destiny. And so if you would just allow me a second to just say a word of prayer, and then I'll go ahead and get into what it is that the Lord has given me to speak about. Amen. Heavenly Father, Lord God, we come before you as humble as we know how. Lord God, we love you and we worship and adore you, Lord God. Father God, we put nothing before you. We trust, Lord God, that you will lead us and guide us and direct us in the path that you would have us to go. And, Lord God, we thank you and we honor you for the words that will come out of your vessel today, that will come out of those who love you and who minister to your children. Lord God, I thank you for each and every one of us, Lord God, and I thank you for keeping us and keeping our minds stayed on you. And Lord God, we bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So the Lord was sharing with me about this setup for destiny. And many of us, it seems that, you know, we are up against a wall, that we are in between a rock and a hard place, that nothing can get worse for us. Nothing can get worse for us, and we're just panting by the water, and we're still trusting God, and we're still believing that he's going to pull through for us, and he's going to bring us through. And, you know, and we always accuse the enemy of, you know, putting stumbling blocks before us. We always accuse the enemy of putting those stumbling blocks. But some of those blocks were set up by God, because he's teaching us and he's processing us to look for greater, to look for more, to look for better, to look for him. Amen. And so, God, this is so hard. Amen. But he told me to tell you that your last, that's right, last is prophetic, folks. He said your last downfall was a setup for your destiny. And, you know, a lot of times people, when they think about falling and getting back up, they think, you know what, I'm going to be promoted. I'm going to be elevated, you know, because of what I just went through. I'm going to be promoted. Okay, at a certain point in time, you're no longer on the steps. You're no longer elevated. You're no longer being promoted, but you are on your way. You are set up on the pathway to your destiny, your desired end, the one that God has established for you, the one that's in his will. And we have to go through some things sometimes to get there, okay? We have to know, according to God's word, that he's working it out. He's working it out for our good. And a lot of times that we don't see things
we don't see what God is doing because we're right in it, you know, and a lot of times we don't see what God has done until we come out of it. But God is in it. He is in control. He was in control from the beginning. He's in control through the middle, and he's going to be in control at the ending of what you're going through. And a lot of times we lose hope, and we start seeing things differently, and we get short-sighted, and our minds start becoming reprobated because we want to see, we want people to prophesy to us things that we want to see. We only want to hear what we want to hear. And we start accepting things that look like and sound like what we want. And it's not the fact. It's not what God wants from us. And, you know, then God has to, when he's ready to put us on that pathway to our destiny, he's got to start separating, you know, because if we don't do it, he's going to do it. He's going to separate us from the goats, so to speak. Separate us from things that he did not ordain for us. And some of those things are people. Amen. And we set them up in a position where they are God-like. And we accept that because that's what we see and that's what we want. But the downfall, the crisis that God has opened our eyes to and allow us to see, it hurts. It hurts. The separation hurts. The downfall, it hurts. We have to expect that. But, you know, and we never see it coming. We never see it coming. But God wants us, our hearts, to not be blocked. God wants us to be able to see him with our hearts. And we keep putting all these blocks, these stumbling blocks, these people, places, and things in position, in places where God wants to be seen. He wants to be acknowledged. He wants to be recognized so he can give us our desired end. He wants us to have a destiny that he ordained for us. And so, and, you know, and we sometimes we even listen to other people tell us stuff about people that we, and we believe those things because it justifies how we feel. Oh, you know what, God wants me to be with this person. He doesn't want me to be with that person. And you got all of these wolves that come around you, and they agree with you, and they agree with you. And so you feel like it justifies what, you know, how you're feeling. And that's out of order. That's wrong. You know, or you have people agreeing with you for what you want, as far as you know, being with a person, and that's the wrong person. But they sit up here, oh, I'm anointed, and I'm you know, I preach the word or whatever, you know, I'm an expert, you know, I got all of these degrees, I can tell you about this, that, and the other. You know what? It's between you and God. You don't need all of the extra. Take it to the Lord. Pray about it, you know, and God will give you the answers. Amen. He will give you the answers. Why? Because we know he loves us. We know that he created us and he designed us and he has a desire in for us and he is our hope. And we should never forget that. And so in moving things out the way, God is moving those things so that we can see him more clearly, so that we can see the road that he's put us on and the destiny and the desire in that he wants us to have peace, love, happiness, joy. He wants us to have all of those things. Oh, amen. And so, amen. You know, life is good and life is wonderful. And, you know, when we think that people leave us, that you know, it's so terrible. It's not. It's not. Because you have to understand that if it was never yours, if this person was never yours and they decide to leave and it's that easy for them to leave, then you never had it. You never did. It was never yours. And so you have to accept that, well, you know what, if this is God's will, then I'm all right with it. You know, I can move on. I can spread my wings because that was a road that was going to lead me to nowhere. I'm not trying to go to Beyonce, but I'm just, Y'all excuse me, but she does have a song about what goes around comes back around, or some of that nature. And so, you know, you dodged the bullet. Just say it like that. You just dodged the bullet. Amen. And so, and just know that God loves us, and that he you know, if he throws a wrench in our program, it was just that. It was our program. It wasn't his. It was our program. And what we need to do is we need to pray for people who, you know, use us and, you know, and mistreat us. We need to pray for those people, and we need to repent. Yeah. I know people want to throw repent in there like it's old rag, you know, but, you know, repenting is so important, because you repent because you put something in the place of where God is supposed to be, and you have a hope in something or someone else that's going to bring you joy and happiness. Well, God says, I'm supposed to be there. I'm supposed to be there by myself. I don't need no help, and I don't need nobody else. This is not your destiny, and that is why I had to move it out of the way, because you were not seeing. You were short-sighted. I've had to move it out of your way. And so be encouraged, people of God. Be encouraged in what God is doing. You just sit back and you say, God, show me your will. Let your will be done in me. You know, God, I know that your will is perfect. Your will is sure, and I have to accept that, you know, and I have to be strong. You know, when we allow things to cause us to fall, we have to get back up. We have to force our way back up. We have to get back to our joy quickly, that we are not lost, that we're not overwhelmed and overtaken by grief. And you have to recognize that, you know, if you're grieving over something so bad, then you made a God out of it, that you can't walk away. You've made a God out of it. And, you know, if you say you love the Lord, you have to fix that. You have to recover yourself. We have a responsibility. It's nobody else's responsibility that if we fall into a position where we are not worshiping and we're not praising and we can't pray no more over things and situations, we got a problem. We are in trouble. We have to respond with a fight to get back to God. We have to, and he expects us to get back to him. Okay, so baby girl or girlfriend or honey, boyfriend or whoever you are, pick yourself back up. Get your nose out the dirt and get yourself back to worship. Repent that you put something in a position that had that much authority and that much control over your life. You are on a pathway to a destiny, to a desired end. That thing that you fell down for, get over it. Get over it and keep moving, because this is not your destiny. Your failure or somebody else's failure or lack thereof is not your destiny. This is not what God had for you. You keep it moving. Come on, somebody. I need you. I need you to forgive yourself. Forgive other people and repent and say, God, you know what? This hurts real bad. And if it hurts this bad, I must have failed you. I must have failed you somehow. And, Lord, I repent. I repent of wanting something, of desiring something, and not waiting on you, and putting myself out there where I'm left to feel this way. I'm left to clean myself up. I'm left to pick myself up, and I'm calling on you when I should have called on you from the beginning, or I should have heard you when you responded. I repent, God. You know, that's what we do. You say, I repent. Lord, forgive me for wanting something that was not you, or was not from you, or was not of you. Lord God, I repent. And that's why I failed. Because, Lord, I refuse to hear you. And I know clearly you were clearly talking to me. You know, I'm just being personal, and I'm being real with people. You know, even our best intentions, we fail. Even with our best intentions, we fail when we can't put God first. And sometimes we do it unconsciously, but as soon as you realize that you repent and you get back on right accord and right standing with God, and you say, Father, you know what? I was sidetracked. I got off the mark, and Lord God, I just need you to put me back in place to reach this destiny that you want me to have. And redeem the time that I lost being foolish. Come on. Help me, God. Help me to redeem the time that I lost being foolish. You know, who wants to go take 40 years in the wilderness? You could have got there in four days, but it took you 40 years, you know, because... Come on. My God. I'm just saying. Let us not, when we fall down, let us not stay down there. Let us not stay down. That was just necessary, and you had to go through it, and you had to get through it. Be glad that God showed you your error. Be glad that he had compassion on you. That he cared enough for you to chastise you, to bring you to your right state of mind. Be glad that what you went through did not kill you. But God has given you another chance to turn it around because he wants you to reach your destiny. I do pray and I do hope that somebody received that word. I do pray and I do hope that it helps somebody where they are. I just feel in my spirit that there are many who found themselves in that position, you know, and the way they were feeling was that I messed up, I'm lost. No, you're not lost. No, you're not lost. Yes, it hurts. Yes, it's supposed to hurt. It's all a process. But God has given you eyes to see into a hope that is your destiny. This ain't it. Amen, people of God. Falling down is not your destiny. Get back up. Keep working it. Keep trusting and hoping and believing in God. He is with you. Repent of your sin. Repent of your error and keep moving because you're trying to get to the destiny. You done been through the steps. You done been through the elevation. We can't even get excited about elevation no more. We excited about destiny. God is doing this. Destiny. Man can't elevate you. Man can't put you in your destiny. Only God can do that. Only God. So this was kind of serious, but this was kind of off the books. Kinda, because I'm always in the Word. I'm always in the Spirit. Amen. And so, just from my heart to yours, I hope you got it. I hope that helped somebody. I hope you're not bleeding anymore. You're not losing fluids because you're draining and you invested in something that did not produce. Keep moving. Shake it off. To God be the glory. And Father God, now I thank you, Lord God. I thank you that you allowed me to be humble. I thank you that you allowed me to come as I am. I thank you, Lord God, that this word was powerful for who it applied to. And it applied to me as well, God. I thank you. And I honor you that you would even give me the lesson to learn. Oh, God, I love you. We love you. And we'll never stop trusting in you, God. Thank you. Thank you for the spirit of correction. Thank you, God, for the spirit of warning. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for restoring us. We love you. And we bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Y'all go forth, recover yourself, and keep moving for your destiny. God bless you.
I was created for, though I believe it.